we will take a look at pluggable database option in Oracle 12c. I will connect to database instance with SQL plus assist EBA. I will query $instanceView to check the instance name, version, and instance status. I will query $DatabaseView to check the database name and CDB column. Here, CDB is yes, meaning this database is a container database and it supports pluggable database option. I have a saved SQL script called pdbs.sql. This contains a simple join on DBA underscore PDBs and $PDBs. Join condition is on PDB name column. Con ID is container ID column. You can see here we don't have any pluggable databases. PDB$seed is created by default along with the container database. It has a container ID of 2. It is always in normal state and it is always opened in read-only mode. Container database ID is always 1 and it is also called as root container. Let us look at the syntax diagrams for create pluggable database. We can create pluggable databases using 3 methods. First method is to create a PDB from seed. Second method is to create a clone of an existing PDB. And the third method is to plug a PDB which was unplugged earlier. In this session, we will check out how to create pluggable databases from PDB$seed. Now let us look at the syntax. Create pluggable database, PDB name. PDB name can be up to 30 characters long, just like any other database object names. Admin user, username identified by password. This user will be the PDB administrator. This user will be a local user in the PDB. By default, PDB underscore DBA role will be granted to the PDB admin user. Using roles clause, we can grant additional roles or privileges to PDB underscore DBA role. Default table space clause can be used to create additional table space for users' data. By default, sys, sysorts, and temp table spaces will be created for PDB. File name convert clause can be used to instruct on how the file names are generated for the PDB. PDB storage clause can be used to define storage limits for the PDB. Max size is the upper limit for the combined total size of all table spaces in the PDB. Max shared temp size is the upper limit of storage in temporary table space for all active sessions connected to the PDB. Path prefix clause can be used to ensure that file paths for directory objects and parameters associated with the PDB are restricted to the specified directory or its subdirectories. Temp file reuse clause can be used to instruct the database to format and reuse a temp file associated with the new PDB if it already exists. Now, we will check out how to create pluggable databases from seed. I will start with simple command. I am using ASM storage and I will depend on Oracle managed files option for file names. Here, I am creating a pluggable database from seed with PDB name as PDB underscore HR with an admin user and a simple password. I will run PDB's query to check the list of PDBs and their status. You can see here we have a newly created PDB in new state and in mount mode. New state means the PDB is newly created and was never opened. Mount mode means the PDB is not open for use. Now, I will create another PDB with more detailed syntax options. I will specify default table space option, but I will ignore data file option. Data file will be created in ASM storage using Oracle managed file names. I will specify storage limits for this PDB. I will run PDB's query to check the list of PDBs and notice that we have created PDB sales. I will exit from SQL Plus. I will create two folders for data and temp data files in the file system for another PDB. I will start SQL Plus again. I will first check data file's location for PDB$seed. We need this location to create our next PDB. Now, I will create PDB marketing. I will specify default table space option along with data file location and data file size. I will specify file name convert option. Source path will be PDB seed data file location. Replacement path will be PDB storage location. I will specify storage limits for this PDB. I will specify path prefix option. This will be same as the path for PDB storage location. I will run PDB's query to checklist of PDBs and notice that we have created PDB marketing. Now, I will create a PDB with errors. I will specify roles option and assign PDB DBA role, which is by default granted to the admin user. This will result in an error while creating PDB. Circular role grant detected. I will run PDB's query to checklist of PDBs and notice that we have a PDB error database in unusable state. I have created 3 PDBs successfully and 1 with errors. Now, I will check data files and temp file locations for PDBs. We can query $data file and $temp file views. As you can see here, PDBHR database files are stored in ASM storage. Thank you. As you can see here, PDB marketing database files are stored in file system. We can check database files related to PDB error. This PDB is in unusable state. I have created 3 PDBs successfully and 1 with errors in this session.